Captain's log, Guybrush Threepwood. Lost at sea for days now. I have no crew or navigational instruments. No provisions except a half-eaten corn dog, and unless I find water soon, I'm surely done for. Only the hope of finding my love, Elaine, keeps me going. Well, my quest for the fabulous treasure called Big Whoop has left me in this sorry state. I thought it would bring me fame and glory. Instead, it delivered me into the clutches of my enemy, the zombie pirate LeChuck. I had thwarted his evil plot to marry Elaine, and he was after revenge. Really thirsty now. If only I could have a small drink of fresh water, I might have the strength to sail on. Oh, but I know there's nothing but ocean for miles and miles. If I could reach land, I might find water and some food. Fruit, maybe. Something to fight off the scurvy and help me get my strength back. Maybe some bananas. Oh, why do I torture myself like this? I might as well wish for some chicken and a big mug of grog for all the good it'll do me. Oh, my sweet Elaine. Am I cursed to starve here on this ocean without seeing your face just one more time? Am I...
Chuck, I just don't feel that way about you.
Elaine?
By my congealed blood, you'll learn to love me. Sail with me, and I'll make you queen of the dead.
I can't. I'm washing my hair tonight.
Blast be your hair, woman! Can't you see that this salty old sea corpse pines for your every gentle caress?
You know, I don't think my father would approve of me dating the undead. And you're probably too nice a zombie pirate for me anyway. Let's just be friends instead. LeChuck, you're an evil, foul-smelling, vile, codependent villain, and that's just not what I'm looking for in a romantic relationship right now.
Darn your riddles, you saucy female! What do you mean? Ah! Oh!
You're a bloodthirsty monster who's already kidnapped me once, tortured my friends, and taken from me the only man I ever loved, Guybrush Threepwood.
Ah, how romantic. Ship ahoy!
Threepwood! Fish him out.
Guybrush?
Guybrush Threepwood, by my gangrenous gut, I don't know how you escaped my carnival of the damned, but you won't escape a taste of my blade! Ah! Ooh, the lass has spirit. Throw him in the hold, I'll finish him after the battle. Turn loose the longboats! And prepare the flaming voodoo cannonball!
I've got to get out of here and help Elaine. If I could only get through this one door, well, then I could easily overpower the armed guards above, slip over the side, and make for the shore.
Quit your mumbling, captive! Stand your distance!
I'm Guybrush Threepwood. Who are you?
I'm the evil pirate Bloodnose, the wickedest fiend ever to sail under the banner of King Death. I'd as soon chew your nose off as look at you.
Are you wearing a fake beard?
Bloodnose the pirate would not have a fake beard.
Yes, it is. It's been glued to your ear hair.
Actually, it's a highly sophisticated beard weave, made from the chest and back hair of real pirates. I'm hoping it'll take root if I don't wash it for a while.
Hey, wait a minute. You're not a pirate. Wally! Don't you recognize me? It's Guybrush Threepwood.
Oh, gee. Hello, Mr. Wood.
The last time I saw you, we were prisoners in LeChuck's dungeon. Why would you sign on with a ship of the living dead?
Well, Mr. Brush, at first I had some misgivings about it. But thanks to LeChuck's seminars, motivational lectures, and audio books on Parrot, I've become a vicious corsair. You can too. Ask me how.
Do you have any literature I could look at?
Here. This leaflet explains the basic philosophy I follow.
I'm not in the mood for sales hype. Snap out of it, Wally!
That's Bloodnose to you, you scurvy sea bass!
You're a failure as a pirate.
Shut your trap, you yellow-bellied blowfish! One more peep out of you, and I'll do you in!
Peep.
You scabrous swab! One more word and I'll let you have it!
Word.
That's it! I'm gonna blast you! I'm gonna... Oh, I can't do it! I just can't! You're right, Mr. Wood! I'm just not a pirate. I'm not ferocious or bloodthirsty or hateful or anything. I'm not even unpleasant. Oh.
Oh, there.
Hey, you're getting a little close there, but...
What were you shooting?
Oops.
Whose side are you on?
Gonna get us all killed again.
It's like
the four of you.
Hey, I'm getting pretty good at this. Ooh, gross. All the bones and stuff are floating towards the ship. I can't quite squeeze past this cannon.
Well, they've messed with the wrong skull this time. Hey, that's my arm. Give that back. Hey.
Steel, feeble cannon restraint rope.
Now, with the demon flames of this voodoo cannonball, I'll blast my significant other into the significant other world. That'll show her how much I truly care. Ah! Neptune's navel. That was a close one.
I lost my cutlass when the ship capsized.
I don't even want to know what LeChuck's plans were for that. No self-respecting pirate would be seen wearing that.
It's a bag of wooden nickels. Some treasure. Hey, there's a big diamond ring behind this bag.
Guybrush? Guybrush! I thought I'd lost you forever. Is it really you?
Yes, Elaine. Did you really mean what you said out there? That I was the only man you ever loved?
Well, yes, Guybrush, I guess I did.
Elaine, I'm a man of action. A swashbuckler, a rogue, a wanderer. A man who can hold his breath for 10 minutes. I have no ties and no regrets. I sail with the wind and go where adventure takes me. But somehow, something always leads me.
Guybrush, stop babbling.
Elaine, will you marry me?
Oh, Guybrush.
Oh, Wally? You're alive. But how did you survive the explosion?
I was thrown clear. I'm just lucky I wasn't wearing my seatbelt. Wow, Elaine, that's some ring.
Thank you, Wally. It's an engagement ring from Guybrush.
Hey, that looks just like the big diamond ring LeChuck had in his treasure hold. You know, the one with that ghastly, disfiguring voodoo curse on it. Well, I'm sure Guybrush wouldn't have given you that ring. Anyway, I gotta be going. I hear there's a tattoo removal place on this island that's freckle safe. See you at the wedding.
Guybrush!
Oh no! Elaine? She's not gonna be happy about this.
Ouch!
I am Murray, the invincible demonic skull. I bring you warning from the infernal realms. Do not go farther into the swamp. Turn back, turn back. Darkness will envelop you.
Do you know anything about lifting curses?
Oh, right. I know a lot about lifting curses. That's why I'm a disembodied talking skull, sitting on top of a spike in the middle of a swamp.
You seem bitter.
I'm sorry, it's been a rough day.
I'd love to stay and chat, but I gotta go.
What a relief.
Wow, I got a whole pack of gum. nice place. I love what you've done with it.
Thank you. You'll have to excuse the mess. The kids came over to play with their paper voodoo dolls. They're adorable children. Would you like to see some pictures?
Perhaps later.
Yes, there's no time for that now. I sense that something terrible has happened.
Hey, you're good. Something terrible has happened. I finally proposed to Elaine.
Congratulations. That doesn't sound so terrible.
And when I placed the engagement ring on her hand, she was placed under a horrible pirate curse and trapped for eternity as a solid gold statue.
Oh, that explains it. I was struck with a wave of overwhelming hatred and anger.
Yeah, that LeChuck was a pretty mean guy.
I was talking about Elaine.
Well, there's no time to worry about that now. We have to hurry.
Do not panic, Guybrush. She will be safe until we can break the curse. You only have to worry about her being stolen. Where did you hide her?
I just remembered something. I've got to go.
You did remember to hide the giant solid gold statue of your girlfriend from all the other pirates on the island?
Well, not exactly, but, you know, I...
Go, Guybrush, hurry, before you're too late.
Elaine! I've got to get her back. This is so embarrassing. Looks like I'm gonna need some more help. Someone's stolen Elaine.
That is unfortunate. It will be difficult to get her back.
Do you know who kidnapped her?
Not for certain, but I suspect that it's the mangy pirates anchored in Danger Cove.
Can you give me something to lift the curse?
No. LeChuck's curse is a very powerful one. Fueled by his anger and his intense frustration in dealing with the opposite sex. I have nothing here to lift so powerful a curse, but there is one way.
Great! Tell me!
You have to replace the cursed ring with a pure one of greater or equal value. A good guideline is 2 months' salary.
Where am I gonna find a huge, uncursed diamond ring?
Legends speak of a whopping big diamond ring on Blood Island.
Blood Island? I've never heard of it.
You will soon become quite familiar with it. But you must be careful, Guybrush. I have foreseen that your journey will be filled with peril and deception. I have also seen that Blood Island will be the place where you will die.
And you're saying this is a place I should go? What are you, nuts?
No. The value of the ring on Blood Island comes from its emotional significance. It represents a pure, true love, a power greater than any other.
Oh, that's sweet. I think I have something in my eye.
Do not mock the voodoo priestess.
How do I get to Blood Island?
You will need 3 things. A map to Blood Island, for the journey is a long and dangerous one. A seaworthy ship to take you there. And an experienced crew.
Map, ship, and crew. Got it. Well, how will I find the ring on Blood Island?
All I can say is that I see a long and painful history connected with that ring. And I feel a great sadness associated with it. You will learn more once you have actually found the island.
Blood Island, here I come! Who did you say kidnapped Elaine?
I suspect it was the work of the pirates anchored in Danger Cove.
Where's Danger Cove?
It is on the west side of the island. The way is extremely treacherous. Few men have seen Danger Cove and lived.
Figures. Well, they're gonna regret messing with my girlfriend. Danger Cove, huh? You might want to stay indoors. This could get messy. Thanks for your help. Gotta go. Feeling down because your chicks turned to gold? Come to the swamp, get your fortune told. Voodoo and things. Formerly just voodoo. Visit our new location on Plunder Island. Watch me make this disappear. Nothing up my sleeve? Presto! Hey, it worked! There's something inside. The A, C's of ventriloquism. Looks like a nice coat. With just a few flakes of unsightly dandruff. I'd hate people to think less of this guy just because of a slight problem with... Hey, this isn't dandruff. Oh! There's a glove in here.
Welcome, patron, to the Barbary Coast.
Where every haircut is an adventure.
Aye, and if you're wanting a haircut, you'll have to wait until I'm finished with Captain Rottingham here.
Are you guys pirate barbers?
We prefer the term buccaneer hairstylists.
Great, maybe you guys can help me find this huge diamond ring I'm looking for.
Diamond ring?
Yeah, it's supposedly enormous, and it's on Blood Island.
Blood Island? Never heard of it.
It's a funny story, really. I need it to lift this curse that's turned my girlfriend into a solid gold statue.
Solid gold?
Wait a second. Did I just share too much? Ahoy there! I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Of course you are!
Okay then, who are you?
Edward Van Helgen.
Not the...
That's right. Mine is the name that pirates fear the most. Edward Snugglecakes Van Helgen.
Dude! How'd you like to join my ever-growing pirate crew?
Your crew? Why would I want to be on your crew?
It's gonna be a blast. We're going to Blood Island.
Sorry, Threepwood. As much as I'd love to be out at sea again, I could never serve a captain who wasn't a gentleman and who wasn't my equal.
Fine, be that way. Whoa, look at the time. Gotta scoot. Ahoy there, I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
So,
it's good to meet you, Mr.
Bill.
Bill? That's your pirate name, Bill?
Cutthroat Bill.
Oh, I see. Well, that puts a whole new spin on it, doesn't it? Are you ever going back to pirating?
Maybe. Someday. If I find the right captain.
Perfect. I'll be your captain. Onward to Blood Island and high adventure. Wanna come?
You a captain? Hardly.
I'm the mighty pirate who defeated LeChuck.
And what do you have to show for it?
I've got a ton of cool stories.
Treasure? Immense mounds of gold and diamonds? Solid gold scepters of power? Anything?
Well, I've got these nickels.
Wooden?
Yeah.
Some treasure hunter you are. You couldn't find gold in a jewelry shop.
I bet I could find gold on this very island.
How much would you bet?
Well, I've got these nickels.
Right. Come back when you have some real treasure to show me.
It's been a pleasure. Bye. You know,
I really appreciate you taking the time to talk to me. I think we've, well, we've bonded.
How did you do that?
Oh, it was nothing, really. Just sudden pressure applied below the sternum to expel a foreign object from the windpipe.
That's amazing. I owe you my life. From now on...
Yes?
From now on, that will be known as the Threepwood Maneuver. Nah.
Ahoy there! I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pie...
Quiet!
Red... Huh?
Don't distract him while he's working on me!
Aye, laddie. You'll have to wait your turn. It's the pirate way. Holy infestation! You've been struck with the hair demons!
What are you talking about?
The cursed head vermin, the scourge of every hygienic sailor on the seven seas!
That's a lie!
Sure as I'm standing here, they're wriggling about your scalp like a pack of wretched sea lions.
Good analogy.
This calls for drastic action. I'm bringing in old Ironsides.
No, no, let's not be too rash.
Rash? That's a bad sign.
There's no time to lose. I'm going to have to amputate.
No! No! You'll ruin my hair!
Ahoy there! I'm Guybrush Threepwood, here to serve all your mighty pirate needs.
Pleasure to meet you, Guybrush. I am Haggis McMutton of the Clan McMutton.
How would you like to join my crew?
You seem like a nice enough sort, Guybrush, but a man cannot serve as my captain unless he earns me respect.
And how would a man go about doing that?
By besting me in a time-honored test of strength.
The 500-meter bucket full of heavy rocks relay?
No, I'm talking about the traditional Highland display of strength and virility, the caber toss.
Sounds great. Let's do it.
I would never follow such a weak captain.
I sure could use a haircut.
Have a seat, laddie, and I'll do you up with a fine coif. Ugh, blast that ineffectual paperweight. I'll have to go find another.
Well, what about my haircut?
Keep your skirt on, lad. I searched the whole island, and I couldn't have found a single rock for a paperweight. I suppose I'll just have to eyeball your haircut.
I just remembered I have another appointment.
Oh, I was going to give you a French braid, too.
It's an informative plaque put up by the Plunder Island Naturalist Society. Ipecac, Cephalus ipecacuana, one of the creeping vines common throughout Plunder Island. The syrup made from the ipecac flowers was used by the early settlers of Plunder Island as a purgative. I wonder what this sign means. Snake crossing. What possible harm could a snake? Well, this isn't good. It makes syrup of ipecac. That seems logical. Whew! That sure was a close one. I thought for sure when I got eaten by that snake that I was done for. Thank goodness I'm safe. No? Hey! Hang on, the quicksand is sucking all the cool stuff I found in that snake from my pants. Now there's an odd sensation. Youch! Well, I got the thorn. I hope that was worth it. I can't move anywhere in this quicksand. Perfect. For once today, things are going... Well, darn. Hey. Thank goodness for those unpredictable Caribbean trade winds. A world-class pea shooter. It's a nice boat, except for that enormous gaping hole in the bottom. It's a reservation slip for Blondebeard's chicken.
Do you have a reservation?
Of course I have a reservation.
Then let's see your reservation slip. Very good. You may seat yourself, Mr. Pardon me. Mrs. Brinestoop.
It is full of maggots.
Aye! That's my special ingredient. Adds just the right amount of exotic flavor.
It's a good thing, too, because I can't keep them out of the food around here.
He's awfully reserved for a pirate. Excuse me, sir? Now that's just rude. Hey, mister. Mister, you listening? Ah! It's one of LeChuck's skeletal horde.
Aye! I fixed his little red dinghy, but good.
The undead that walk among us must surely be destroyed, lest their evil-like overrun and befoul the world of the living.
Aye. And he complained about me checking.
Oh. It says, ask me about Grim Fandango. Ugh. Brimstone Beach Club. Member since 1632. Excuse me, but...
What a lucky pirate are ye!
Me?
You've struck gold, boy!
I have?
Gold! 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 Ha-ha! Gold and nuggets of chicken!
Oh.
A treasure trove of deep-fried fun! Now, what can kindly old Captain Blondebeard bring ye for lunch?
Nothing for me, thanks.
It'd be just as well. Actually, I'm out of just about everything. Not a drumstick left. All I have left are those biscuits and a few tubs of our special Ipecac slaw.
How's the Ipecac slaw?
Not bad. But 15 minutes later, you'd be hungry again.
Nice gold tooth you have there.
Aye! It glistens like the golden topping of grease on me luscious batter-fried chicken.
I'll let you get back to work.
Aye.
Would you like this jawbreaker?
Thanks to ye! Ouch! I think I loosed me gold tooth! Arr, I knew sweets were being bad for me teeth! But it had a fine crunch and were a fiesta of flavor. From now on, I'll be sticking to fleshier foodstuffs. Something chewy. Well, there I go again. This old salt's got a craving for something to squish between me teeth.
Would you like some gum?
Thanks. This is really good steak-flavored gum. It gets you here. And it gets you right here. Why, you little scamp. That's quite a funny trick you've played on old Cap'n Blondebeard.
Gold tooth is in the gum.
Oh, that's made my voice sound funny. Cool.
Wait one second. Do you have me, Gold Tooth?
No.
Let me see. You don't have it. Darn, I'll have to order a new one.
I wonder where that tooth fell. Hey, it's the Gold Tooth. Sumatran rubber tree. Donated to Puerto Pollo by our Sumatran sister city of Vacaville, this tree is the only one of its kind in the entire Western Hemisphere and stands as an everlasting symbol of the friendship between our two cities. Caribbean rubber tree. One of the many rubber trees common throughout the Caribbean, used as raw material for shipbuilding. Spinning. I gotta lay off the rum. Check this out.
Is that real gold? I guess you can find treasure.
So, you'll join my crew?
Sure, as long as my partners will join too.
I'll need two more sailors for my crew. Are you sure you don't want to join my crew?
It's as I told you, Guybrush. Not until you can best me in the caber toss.
Sounds great. Let's do it. Hey, I win!
By the spiraling bouffant of my great uncle McManus! Never before have I seen such strength. Sure, I'll join your crew. I'll wait at the shop until you're ready to leave.
I'll need one more sailor for my crew.
Now there's a challenge. To the field of honor. Choose your weapon.
I choose the banjo.
I accept.
You do?
You're pretty good, boy. Let's see you follow this.
He's good. I'll never beat him.
Shot my banjo.
You can't be sure of that. That shot may have come from the grassy knoll.
Of all the low-down tricks, I never heard of anything so low. I completely misjudged you. You are a pirate after all. I'd be proud to join your crew.
Great.
I'll just pack this stuff up and get ready. And give me back my gun.
Well, I got my whole crew.
A barrel of grog and a chicken. Look at all this stuff, mate. Oh, that must have been some battle. Let's pull up anchor and make for Skull Island. King Andre will pay through the nose for all this loot.
Wait a minute. There's something else. It's some kind of footwear. Hey, those are nice boots. They're still hot. Ow.
Yes, may I help you?
My name is Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pirate.
Threepwood? You must be Seersucker Skip Rackham's cousin. How are Muffy and the twins?
Who?
Hey, it's a lovely afternoon for the beach today. Not too crowded yet. There's a crafts workshop on the south beach, and a swabber-sized class at 2 and 4. Water's warm and the waves aren't too high. Just watch out for the occasional undead corpse washing up on shore. Might want to keep the kids away from any rotting flesh. But otherwise, the siege earlier today shouldn't spoil your afternoon. Just between you and me, the undead are notoriously bad tippers. So it's just as well they didn't take over the island, eh? Let me see your membership card and we'll fix you right up.
Why?
You're at the Brimstone Beach Country Club in Smorgy, part of the Leisure Lovers Planned Community for Retired Pirates. It's very exclusive. I'm afraid if you don't have a membership card, you cannot use any of the club's amenities.
I don't want an amenity. I had to eat one of those while I was lost at sea, and it was terrible.
Then let me also point out that without that membership card, you are not permitted on the beach, you cannot use any of our towels, and you can't have anything from the grill. Good day.
Excuse me.
Yes, you filthy little man.
My card.
Let me see that. Oh, no! In the name of all things clean, you've got a membership.
Yes. And I think I'll just take one of your fluffy clean towels and enjoy a nice, relaxing stroll down your beach.
No! You mustn't!
I must. And perhaps I'll sunbathe nude.
Sweet mother of pearl, no! Now that I think about it, it is nice out on the far end of the beach. You should go there. You should go there now.
Nice fluffy towel. I'll just take one more. Towels are all wet now. With these holes in my shoes, I'll never get across that hot beach. I'm Guybrush Threepwood.
Very nice to meet you, Mr. Threewood. I am Pálido. Pálido Domingo. I am so glad you're here.
Finally. Someone on this island with some manners.
And my drink needs refreshing. Take it away and bring me another.
I'm looking for Blood Island. Do you know where it is?
Nope. Never heard of it.
Are you sure you don't know how to get to Blood Island?
I told you before, babe. I've never heard of Blood Island.
See you around. I'll have to buy some lemonade first. Hello there, Sonny. You open yet?
Oh boy, oh boy! My first customer. Gee willikers, is this gonna be swell. Hi, my name's Kenny. Kenny Foulmouth. It sure would be neat if you would buy some of my lemonade. It only costs a nickel. And best of all, I have a bottomless mug policy.
That does sound like a good deal. I'd like to buy some lemonade.
Sure. We have a bottomless mug policy, you know. That'll be a nickel.
Hey! There's no bottom to this mug. Give me my money back.
I'm sorry. I did tell you about our bottomless mug policy. And there are no refunds.
Why, you little...
Thank you. Come again.
Look! A three-headed monkey!
Oh boy, oh boy! Gee willikers, is this gonna be swell! Hey!
Just because you're a grown-up doesn't mean you can waste my time.
Give me some more lemonade, you little chiseler.
That'll be a nickel!
That was as refreshing as morning dew.
Hey! How did you drink all the lemonade? You switched mugs on me, you cheat. I hope you're happy. You put a budding young entrepreneur out of business.
It's full of dye now. I've brought you a new mug.
Thanks.
Here's your drink, sir.
Look, Pálido, you're burning.
Ah, all those months in the sun and my tan is just gonna peel away. I better turn over.
Good idea.
I'll never memorize that map. It's far too complex. I really wish I didn't have to do that.
Nice boots, huh?
Sorry.
Hey, what do you know? I really am Big Bone.
Uh-oh, quiet! Here comes Captain LeChuck.
Avast there, you lubbers! Set sail for my stronghold on Monkey Island. I'll unleash my entire army of the undead. This time, Elaine will be mine. Ah, Elaine. 'Twill be a sweet day in hell when you feel the fiery breath of my kiss on your lips and become my undead bride. And I'll destroy any man who dares get in my way! Suffering sailors, 'tis good to be dead!
The plug is all pasty now. Perfect.
On a dead man's, huh? Who are you?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm a mighty pirate.
Well, we'll just see how your threats sit with my captain.
Your captain?
Yes, Threepwood. You've come aboard the Sea Cucumber. I am Mr. Fossey, the first mate. And my captain? Why, he's the scourge of the seven seas, the dread pirate. Yes, Captain. It's on the table, sir.
LeChuck!
That's right. Captain LeChuck. Yes, Captain. Just an intruder, sir. But I'm dealing with him. He says you're to be tortured. Choose your punishment. You can either be tarred and feathered, or you can walk the plank.
Well, I walked that plank thing on the way up. Good enough?
No. Sorry. Well, I suppose we'll have to go with walking the plank. We're trying to avoid using the tar and feathers. It's messy, and we need to save the tar for emergency leak repair. What do you say, men? Shall we make him walk the plank? Any last words, Threepwood?
I regret that I have but one life to give for love.
All right. In you go! That's odd. There was no splash.
Splash!
Who's there?
Again with the sneaking on board the ship!
I don't know how or why you came back on board.
But the next time you walk the plank will be your last! What's that, Captain? Vandals? Yes, sir. Tar and feathers. I know it's messy, but it's the only torture we have left. Our illustrious captain has declared that you shall be tarred and feathered. That'll learn ya.
So what do I do now?
I don't know. We've never done this before. Aren't you humiliated?
I guess so, but no more than usual.
Well, just get lost then.
Do you have a reservation? Madre de Dios! Es el Pollo Diablo!
Sí, he dejado en libertad los prisioneros y ahora vengo por ti.
Well, you're not taking me without a fight!
Ugh, this chicken grease washed off all the feathers. Whoops, I better keep quiet.
Absolutely, Captain. I'll get right on it after I have my dinner. What's that, Captain? I eat too much fried chicken. Well, I've just got a weakness for chicken, that's all. I know you don't have any weaknesses, Captain LeChimp. You're an overachiever, a doer. I'm just a tiny little fly.
LeChimp? The Captain is an ape? Well, if the Captain is an ape, then Mr. Fossey must be...
Aye, aye, Captain! Fresh bananas for the whole crew!
An utter loon.
What's that, Captain? Your parasites are bothering you. Well, of course I'll groom you, sir. You know, sir, finding this gold statue may be just the boost our crew needs. Why, with the riches we get from this, we can get new and better ships and become the terror of the Caribbean!
Mr. Fossey, I've been thinking.
Are you all right, Captain? You sound different.
Don't interrupt.
Sorry, sir.
Maybe it's time we gave up pirating. I mean, take a look around at me, at the rest of the crew. We're all monkeys.
You mean in the Darwinian sense, sir?
No, I mean in the quite literal sense. Have you noticed that the crew is happier swinging from the masts than swabbing the decks? I don't even want to mention what they've been flinging around the ship.
Are you suggesting that I'm not disciplining the crew enough?
No, I'm suggesting that we all give up this charade and go back to the trees. That's the life for a monkey, not sailing the seas for months on end.
Well, if you feel so strongly about it, sir, I suppose I can't argue.
I think our last order of business should be to dig up that statue and...
It'll be tough on the men, sir, but I'll tell them that you think it best.
Okay, but first we should dig up that statue and give it to...
I'll make sure they understand that it's not their fault.
Very good. And then we can dig up that statue and... Okay, never mind then. That must be the map to where they've buried Elaine. It's two tickets for the Long John Silver Center for the Performing Arts. It smells like something's burning. Must be this shoddy 17th century electrical wiring. Wait a second. Somebody's been monkeying around with these controls. Must be where Elaine is buried.
And now, the moment I know you've all been waiting for. How about some amazing juggling?
Uh-oh. It looks like he's coming for the cannonballs now.
And now the ultimate Shakespearean delight. The famous cannonball juggling scene from Romeo and Juliet. Whoa! Whoops!
I'm glad it had a happy ending and he got the, got the girl in the end. Elaine should be safe up in the crow's nest. For now. Well, I've got a crew, a map, a ship, and finally got Elaine back. So let's say we head on to Blood Island to lift the curse and save Elaine! How about it, guys? Let's get moving towards Blood Island. Let's head on out and find our fortune, guys. This might be more difficult than I first imagined.
Ah, the sea.
Aye, the sea. Makes you glad to be alive.
I think that ship is following us.
Feel that salty spray.
The sunlight sparkling off the bay.
What a glorious seafaring day.
It's a pirate ship. We've got to outrun her. All right, men, are you with me?
Hey, look, guys, a whale.
Where?
Where? That ship is gaining on us. Cutthroat Bill, rig the topsail.
Is that a right whale?
No lie.
They're boarding us. Crew, help me out here.
It is a member of the Cetus suborder, Mr. Shetty, though.
I think you're right.
Well.
Rottingham, so it's you. What do you want, other than a good toupee?
I've come for your map to the fabled Blood Island. Then I'll find the diamond you mentioned. It'll make a fine paperweight for my escritoire.
Ooh, look! It's breaching!
Ooh!
Ah!
Look, Baldy, I'll never give you that map. I need it to save Elaine.
Then I'll have to take it from you by force.
That whale must be 30.5 meters.
100 feet.
And weigh 200 metric tons.
You know of course. In a sword fight, a sharp wit is much more important than a sharp blade.
Of course. Everybody knows that, Chrome Dome. Let's get this over with.
Every enemy I've met, I've annihilated.
Oh, yeah? Well, you fight like a cow.
No. That's not right at all.
What?
On the sea, we fight it a little differently. On the sea, all your insults and threats have to rhyme.
What?
So when I say every enemy I've met, I've annihilated, you say...
I once found some gold, but it was just electroplated?
No, you say, with your breath, I'm sure they are suffocated. Let's try that again, shall we? You're as repulsive as a monkey in a negligee. I'm waiting.
I...
Just as I thought. You're an amateur with this world. Give me that map.
Here, take it.
That's your map? Yeah. As soon as I'm through pirating these waters, it's off to Blood Island. Until we meet again, Monsieur Tweepood.
I've got to get that map back or we'll never find Blood Island. Thanks, guys. You were a world of help back there.
It was a rousing battle, Captain.
Aye, and it reminds me of a song. We're a band of vicious pirates,
a sailing out to sea.
When you hear our gentle singing,
you'll be sure to turn and flee.
Oh, this is just ridiculous.
Come on, men. We've got to recover that map.
That pirate will be done for when he falls into our trap. We're a club of tuneful rovers.
We can sing in every clef.
We can even hit the high notes.
It's just too bad we're tuned deaf.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea.
Let's go defeat that evil pirate. We know he's sure to lose because we know just where to fire it.
We're thieving balladeers.
A gang of cutthroat mugs.
To fight us off, you won't need guns.
Just jolly good earplugs.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea.
All right, crew, let's get to work.
Our vocation's a thing we love, a thing we'd never shirk. We'll fight you in the harbor.
We'll battle you on land.
But when you meet singing pirates,
there'll be more than you can stand.
Oh, that was a good one.
No, it wasn't.
No time for song. We've got to move.
The battle will be long, but our courage we will prove. We're a pack of scurvy sea dogs.
Have we pity, not a dram?
We all eat roasted garlic.
Then sing from the diaphragm.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea.
Less singing, more sailing.
When we defeat our wicked foe, his ship he will be bailing.
Try to fight us.
You will get a nasty whacking.
If you disrespect our singing,
we will feed you to a kraken.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea.
I'm getting so sick of you guys and your rhyming.
We're ready to set sail, though the cannons need a priming.
Troublesome corsairs,
and we've come to steal your treasures.
We would shoot you on the downbeat,
but we gotta rest 5 measures.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea.
Stop, stop, stop.
The brass is what we'll polish, and the deck is what we'll mop.
You say you're nasty pirates, steaming, thieving, babbush whackers. From what I've seen, I tell you, you're not pirates, you're just slackers.
A pirate I was meant to be. Trim the sails and roam the sea. Roam the sea.
We'll surely avoid scurvy if we all eat an orange.
And,
Well... Door hinge?
No, no.
Guess the song's over then.
Guess so.
Okay, back to work.
Well, gee, I feel a little guilty now.
Captain.
Yes, Mr. McMutton.
We were wondering, we were, just what kind of captain you are.
What do you mean, Haggis?
Well, some captains are men of action. They like to have complete responsibility and control for their ship. Other captains prefer to concentrate more on the thinking aspects of captaining. The captain who's a man of action will undoubtedly have a much more difficult time of defeating other scoundrels of the sea in the fast-paced realm of ship-to-ship combat. The more academic captain will find the other pirate vessels he meets to be less aggressive, and therefore far easier and quicker to defeat in combat.
I see.
So, Captain Threepwood, Which type of captain be ye?
I think I'd rather let you guys help me out.
Easy ship combat it is.
Your life.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
Every enemy I've met, I've annihilated.
Oh, yeah?
You're as repulsive as a monkey in a negligee.
I look that much like your fiancé? Heaven preserve me. You look like something that's died.
My ship has barnacles on its underside.
I've never seen such clumsy sword play.
Oslo is the capital of Norway.
Ha! I've beaten you! I will let you live if you give me your treasure.
I haven't got any treasure. Why do you think I was attacking you? I guess I need more practice with this sword fighting stuff. At least I showed him in the high seas combat part.
You'd better leave now if you value your life.
I've come to plunder your treasure.
I'll see you clapped in irons first.
I have never seen such clumsy swordplay.
You would have, but you were always running away. Coming face to face with me must leave you petrified.
I'm waiting for these feelings of nausea to subside.
I'll hound you night and day.
What this island needs is a good, reasonable buffet.
I fancy you have treasure. Hand it over.
I haven't got any treasure. Why do you think I was attacking you?
You'd best sail away before you get hurt.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
Every enemy I've met, I've annihilated.
With your breath, I'm sure they all suffocated. When your father first saw you, he must have been mortified.
It pays to keep a glass of water at your bedside.
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
I was thrown off a subway because I had expectorated.
Ha! I've beaten you! I will let you live if you give me your treasure.
Treasure? You wanted treasure? I'm sorry, I'm fresh out.
If you're looking for a fight, you've found one.
Give me your treasure and I'll let you live.
No! I'll take your booty!
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
Oh, yeah?
When your father first saw you, he must have been mortified.
Oh, yeah?
I have never seen such clumsy swordplay.
I'm shaking. You win!
Give me your treasure.
The treasure is yours.
We're loaded with booty. Well. I guess you've learned an important lesson about cheating.
I sure have, mister. Golly, I'll never cheat on anyone ever again. Honest, I've got a new business now, and gosh, it's swell.
What is it?
I'm running guns.
Tell me you're lying.
I never lie anymore, mister. You've shown me the light. Can I interest you in some shrapnelizing ammunition designed to bring exquisite pain and unreasonable suffering to all your enemies?
What do you have for sale today?
Today, customer name here, What's your name again?
Guybrush Threepwood.
Today, Mr. Leapgood, I can offer you the complete line from Bob's Big Board Boomer Brand Cannon Incorporated. To start with, we have the entry-level model, the Buccaneer's Buddy. We also have the following cannon models available. The Ouchmaster, the Hoemaker Deluxe, the Pain Giver 2000, Mr. Massacre, and finally, the cannon used by that most fearsome scoundrel, Rene Rottingham himself, the Destructomatic T-47. So, can I interest you in any of these models, mister?
I'll take the Buccaneer's Buddy.
The Buccaneer's Buddy it is. Let me just check my stock. Yep, we got him. You will not be disappointed, my friend. Now, will that be doubloons, jewels, captured maidens?
My ship's hull is full of booty.
Well, the amount in your treasure hold is not enough for this model.
Would you take my old cannons as a trade-in?
Well, I don't know. They are pretty banged up. Hang on while I check the blue book on them. Okay. I'll have my mom install your new cannon pronto. While she's at it, I'll also have her pick up the appropriate amount from your hold and pick up your trade-in. Mom!
How dare you attack me, ship?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
When your father first saw you, he must have been mortified.
I'm shaken. I'm shaken.
I have never seen such clumsy swordplay.
I'm shaken. I'm shaken.
Heaven preserve me, you look like something that's died.
I'm shaken, I'm shaken. You win!
Give me your treasure.
Take it. It was cluttering up the hold anyway.
We're loaded with booty.
Back again, mister?
I'd like to buy some cannons for my pirate ship. I'll take the Ouchmaster.
The Ouchmaster it is. Mom!
So, you're a pirate, says he. You'll have to prove it, says I.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
If you don't count all the ones you've dated. I'll skewer you like a sow at a buffet.
A dentifrice helps prevent tooth decay.
You're as repulsive as a monkey in a negligee!
I look that much like your fiancé? I'll hound you night and day.
Oh, yeah?
Coming face to face with me must leave you petrified.
I'm shaking. I'm shaking. You win!
Give me your treasure. Yeah, grubby bilge swigger.
Take it. It was cluttering up the hold anyway.
We're loaded with booty.
Back again, mister?
I'd like to buy some cannons for my pirate ship. I'll take the Hoemaker Deluxe.
One whole Maker Deluxe coming right up. Mom!
A pox on you for boarding me ship.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
I'm shaking.
I'll skewer you like a sow at a buffet.
I'm shaking.
When your father first saw you, he must have been mortified.
At least mine can be identified. I'll leave you devastated, mutilated, and perforated.
Chinese food's best when not monosodium glutamated.
I can't rest till you've been exterminated.
I think that all criminals should be incarcerated.
Open your hold so I may take your treasure.
Treasure? You wanted treasure? I'm sorry, I'm fresh out.
How dare you attack me ship?
Give me your treasure and I'll let you live.
Arr!
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
If you don't count the ones you've dated. Throughout the Caribbean, my deeds are celebrated.
I wonder if the rent on my ship is prorated.
I can't rest till you've been exterminated.
I like music that's syncopated.
Give me your treasure.
Treasure? You wanted treasure? I'm sorry, I'm fresh out.
You'd better leave now if you value your life.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
I'll leave you devastated, mutilated, and perforated.
Your odor alone makes me aggravated, agitated, and infuriated. Every enemy I've met, I've annihilated.
With your breath, I'm sure they all suffocated. Heaven preserve me, you look like something that's died.
Oh, yeah?
I'll hound you night and day.
I am rubber, you are glue. You win.
Give me your treasure, you reeking, musty, stench-soaked freebooter.
The treasure is yours.
We're loaded with booty.
Back again, mister?
I'd like to buy some cannons for my pirate ship. I'll take the Pain Giver 2000.
The Pain Giver 2000 it is. Mom!
So you're a pirate, says he. You'll have to prove it, says I.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
I'll skewer you like a sow at a buffet.
When I'm done with you, you'll be a boneless fillet. I can't rest till you've been exterminated.
I like music that's syncopated.
I'll hound you night and day.
The air is much less humid around Santa Fe.
I fancy ye have treasure. Hand it over.
Well, if I had any, you'd be the first one to get it.
Arr. You'd better leave now if ye value your life.
I've come to plunder your treasure.
You won't live to regret this.
I'll hound you night and day.
I'm shaken.
I can't rest till you've been exterminated.
Then perhaps you should switch to the caffeinated. I'll skewer you like a sow at a buffet.
When I'm done with you, you'll be a boneless filet. Throughout the Caribbean, my great deeds are celebrated.
Too bad they're all fabricated. Heaven preserve me! You look like something that's died!
My ship has barnacles on its underside.
Ha! I've beaten you! I let you live if you give me your treasure!
Treasure? You wanted treasure? I'm sorry, I'm fresh out.
Who are you?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
Heaven preserve me, you look like something that's died.
The only way you'll be preserved is in formaldehyde. I can't rest till you've been exterminated.
Then perhaps you should switch to decaffeinated. Coming face to face with me must leave you petrified.
I am rubber, you are glue.
You're the ugliest monster ever created.
If you don't count all the ones you've dated, would you like to be buried or cremated?
This isn't going as well as I'd anticipated.
Give me your treasure!
Well, if I had any, you'd be the first one to get it.
Arr. You'd best sail away before you get hurt!
Give me your treasure and I'll let you live.
You won't live to regret this.
Would you like to be buried or cremated?
Oh, yeah.
I have never seen such clumsy swordplay.
You would have, but you're always running away. I'll skewer you like a sow at a buffet.
When I'm done with you, you'll be a boneless filet. I'll hound you night and day.
Oh, yeah? You win!
Give me your treasure.
Take it. It was cluttering up the hold anyway.
We're loaded with booty.
Back again, mister?
I'd like to buy some cannons for my pirate ship. I'll take the Mr. Massacre brand cannon.
One Mr. Massacre coming right up. Mom!
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
Don't make me laugh.
Would you like to be buried or cremated?
With you around, I'd prefer to be fumigated.
Throughout the Caribbean, my great deeds are celebrated.
Too bad they're all fabricated. I'll hound you night and day.
Then be a good dog. Sit! Stay! I'll leave you devastated, mutilated, and perforated.
Your odor alone makes me aggravated, agitated, and infuriated. Coming face to face with me must leave you petrified.
I am rubber, you are glue. You win!
Give me your treasure.
The treasure is yours.
We're loaded with booty.
Back again, mister?
I'd like to buy some cannons for my pirate ship. I'll take the Destructomatic T-47.
Whoa, mister. You've entered a select group of pirates. You've just ordered the Destructomatic T-47 armor-piercing carnage delivery system with auto-loading and fax modem. Quite a fine piece of hardware, if I do say so myself. Mom!
Well, well, well. Look who has washed up on my deck.
Give me my map, you fiend.
This may prove amusing.
Your mother wears a toupee.
I look that much like your fiancé?
I can't tell which of my traits has you the most intimidated.
Your odor alone makes me aggravated, agitated, and infuriated.
You're a disgrace to your species. You're so undignified.
At least mine can be identified.
When I'm done, your body will be rotted and putrefied.
The only way you'll be preserved is in formaldehyde.
Nothing can stop me from blowing you away!
I look that much like your fiancé?
I give you a choice. You can be gutted or decapitated.
With you around, I'd prefer to be fumigated.
My skills with a sword are highly venerated.
Too bad they're all fabricated.
Nothing on this earth can save your sorry hide.
The only way you'll be preserved is in formaldehyde.
Sacrebleu! I cannot believe it! I have been defeated in battle!
So give me that map, take your ship, and skedaddle.
You win, you win. You'll get your map back.
You were doomed from the start, you kleptomaniac.
All right, I give up already.
It's no wonder you lost with a sword so unsteady.
Merci, I beg you, no more insults, please.
Your smell and face remind me of moldy old cheese.
Ah!
We got the map back. Now we can sail to Blood Island. I guess I blacked out for a second. Where's Elaine?
She flew a wee bit into the woods when we crashed.
Then let's get going. We'll find her, then scour the island for the uncursed diamond ring that'll transform her back to normal.
I don't be thinking we will, lad.
What do you mean? I mean, what do you mean, Haggis?
This be a mutiny, Captain. We're leaving you.
Did I mention that I'm offering my crew a very attractive pension plan?
You did. And the stock options. But we're still leaving.
But why, Haggis? Why?
Well, I admit being your pirate crew's been a real pleasure. A real pleasure. But we've grown restless. We can hear the voice of the siren calling to us, and she says she'd be wanting us to do her hair.
You're going back to being barbers?
Aye. We'll be sailing back to Plunder Island just as soon as we can fix the ship. Good luck, Captain Driftwood. It were a pleasure to be looting with you.
I guess I'm on my own again.
You'd best believe in that. That there hand lotion be for the rough, dry skin that can often accompany ship repair.
Haggis?
Aye?
My, that's a big bottle of lotion you have there.
That's right, she be. And don't ye be getting any ideas about stealing it. We're sure to be needing it, you see. Carpentry on this tropical climate can and will prematurely age your skin. 'Tis but one of the many hardships a pirate must face daily during this barbarous age. Aye. And if we pirates didn't carry hand lotion aboard all our ships, we'd probably die from the chafing.
Wow, if I were doing a history report on pirates and I included that fact, I'd get an A+. We're talking guaranteed A+. And that A+ just might get you into the college of your choice. Think about it. There's no way that I can have even a drop of lotion?
Well, maybe we could make a deal. You see, we need to be repairing the ship. She's leaky as a colander. And for some unknown reason, the ship's supplies of tar have been depleted. How the previous crew could set sail without any tar aboard eludes me. But the fact is, unless we get us some tar or something like it, we're doomed to this island for good. Aye, I'd give you the whole bloomin' bottle of lotion if you could find me something to patch the ship so we can be on our way home.
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you.
I feel a dark presence coming over me.
Hi there.
Ah!
Ah! Please, keep it down. No screaming. Oh, my head.
Hi, I'm Guybrush. And you would be?
I am Madame Zima, mistress of the ancient arts, a precognition and augury, diva of divination.
Cool, you're a fortune teller.
Ah, that and so much more.
Whatever. Tell me my fortune.
I do not think you wish to hear. There are things of which a man is better off being ignorant.
Oh, but I'm already ignorant of so many things. I want to know my future.
No, you are not meant to know.
I bet you just can't do it. That's the problem. You can't do it, and you're afraid everyone will find out you're just a phony.
You know, I could put a curse on you that would make every morsel of food you eat become a ravenous cockroach inside your intestines, giving you the most excruciating death imaginable.
So, are you gonna tell me my fortune or not?
I'm not kidding.
Okay, okay. What's in the cards for me? Fame? Fortune? Romance?
Ah, very well. We will consult the cards. The process of reading the tarot is a very complex one. Each draw of the cards foretells an upcoming event in your life. When assembled, they will tell the story of your future. A future filled with twists and... Ah!
Good Lord, woman, stop that screaming.
What is it? Is that a good... Ah!
It is death.
Well, in the tarot, death just means change, right? I mean, it's nothing to get worried about, right?
Sure, whatever you say. Now, please go.
There must be some mistake. Read my tarot cards again.
There is no mistaking your fate, Guybrush. The cards do not lie. But if you insist, once again, it is death.
I'm feeling luckier. Give me another tarot reading.
Luck is not involved here, Guybrush. It is your destiny.
Whatever. Let's see what the cards say this time.
The card says death.
Are you sure you're not dealing from the bottom of the deck?
Remember that curse I told you about?
Okay, okay. Hit me.
Death.
How many of those cards do you have, anyway? How about giving me one more tarot reading?
This is evil work, Guybrush. The fates have conspired against you, and no man can interfere. Your path has been determined.
Okay, I get your point. I really do. Just one more time for Guybrush. Let me guess. Death?
Leave this place.
Huh?
You are putting us all in grave danger. Your very presence will bring us nothing but sickness, tragedy, and death.
Oh, yeah? Well...
Demon! Demon!
Look, a three-headed monkey.
Then the prophecies were true. Where? I don't see anything.
They must have run away.
This is a very bad omen.
Hi, I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I'm...
Stop yelling.
I wasn't yelling, I was just...
I've got a terrible hangover. Find something to clear my head and I can talk to you. And keep it down.
me. Okay, fella, this won't hurt a bit. Hey, I guess it didn't hurt a bit. You must be shedding. Here's a wild pepper for your hangover remedy.
Shh. Thanks.
I found this egg for your hangover remedy.
Shh. Thanks.
This is some of the hair of the dog that bit me.
Shh. Thanks. That's all the ingredients I need. Let me quietly mix up a dose. Ah, much better. Here, you can take the rest.
I don't believe we've met. Who are you?
I am Griswold, last of the good soups and proprietor of this hotel. You may have heard of us and our soup restaurant resort empire that stretches across the Caribbean.
Well...
This was once our proudest resort. In recent years, however, hard times have befallen the family Good Soup and left me alone in this rotting hotel. The Good Soup Plantation Resort Hotel and Casino.
What do you know about the Lost Ring of Blood Island?
Oh, that's a very sad chapter in my family's history. My great-aunt Minnie Stroney Good Soup was a well-to-do member of Blood Island Society. Her one weakness was her romantic nature. She had a thing for pirates, one in particular. He came into port, she fell instantly in love, and they were engaged within the week. Then, on the eve of their wedding, he stole the fantastic Good Soup diamond from her ring and sold it to smugglers on Skull Island. She wore the empty engagement band on her finger until the day she died, which was not long after. Some say she still haunts the Good Soup family tomb. It is a sad story, is it not?
Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry, I wasn't listening. Could you repeat that?
Get lost, Chowderhead.
Hypothetically, how would one get into your aunt's tomb?
I suppose you would have to die.
Oh, crud. I'd like a drink, please.
Sure. What will you have?
Give me a big fruity drink with an umbrella in it.
Good choice. It's a delicious taste of the islands. Made with lemon, grapefruit, and ground beef.
Hey, don't I get one of those decorative umbrellas to go in my tropical drink?
I don't think we have any. No, I'm wrong. I do have this one.
Head be clear, for clearing foggy heads. That opened it. That makes the drink oh so much more appealing. It just occurred to me that mixing medicine and alcohol is a really stupid and possibly lethal thing to do. If I were a real person instead of a lovably inept cartoon character with the potential for a few more sequels, I wouldn't even consider it. Skull! That's odd. It's supposed to cause drowsiness. I don't feel the least bit drowsy.
In fact, I feel...
So then the Undertaker says, I wanted to be a pallbearer, but I couldn't stop coughing.
You crack me up, Mort.
So what's with the new guy?
Oh, he's been like that for an hour now. Passed out cold. He'll come around.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure he's dead.
I guess that's the end of the game, then.
What with him being the main character and all. Funny. I didn't think you could die in LucasArts adventure games.
Well, maybe they're trying something different.
When I should take care of him?
Would you? It's bad for business, having him just lie there.
Rest in peace and all that.
Hey! I'm not really dead. Oh, come on, cut it out. It won't open. I'm trapped. I can't use the mallet with that. It sure is dark. Yikes. Where's that telltale pounding coming from? It's coming from within one of these coffins. From the dead. The dead that surround me. They must know my horrible secret. They'll never let me rest until I've paid for the wrongs I've committed against. Wait a second. I don't have a horrible secret.
I'm glad to be finally out of that thing, even though it was a spacious, comfortable model with plenty of leg and headroom. Well, hello there. Say, you look familiar. Of course! Guybrush Threepwood. You're the one who locked me in there in the first place.
Well, you see, I've been meaning to...
No, I won't hear of it. That was the best time of my life. Gave me plenty of time to think, you know? to think about the things that really matter. I don't know if you've considered this, son, but live burials are not an altogether uncommon experience here in the Caribbean.
I wasn't aware of that.
Not to mention pirate raids and deadly sea battles, huge man-eating reptiles, dangerous quicksand pits, trigger-happy do lists, and of course, those pesky undead. Have you ever thought of what would happen to your loved ones should this gruesome fate befall you?
No, but...
Well, of course, you have plenty of time to think about it. Or do you? I'm one of the lucky ones. I've been dead. It's given me a whole new perspective on life. A life that I'm going to devote to making sure people's life insurance needs are met. Here, take one of my business cards I've had made up.
If you've been locked in that coffin, how are you able to have business cards made?
Now's not the time to worry about the technicalities, son. Now's the time to ask yourself, are you covered? Run along now and let me set up my office.
We're trapped in here. The door's locked.
Nonsense! This is one of Stan's cozy crypts, all equipped with a patented secure lock release mechanism. Just jiggle the handle there. Welcome back to Mutual of Stan.
You've convinced me. I want to buy some insurance.
A wise choice, and one you won't soon regret. The question isn't whether or not you can afford to buy an insurance policy. It's whether you can afford not to. Speaking of which, can you afford to buy an insurance policy?
Well, how much does it cost?
Oh, that depends on a variety of factors. How much coverage you need, how much you're willing to spend, all sorts of highly complicated sliding scale insurance equations and such. But I won't bore you with all that. Just let me ask you this. How much money do you have?
Well, I've got these wooden nickels.
I see. Maybe I've confused you somewhere along the line. While nothing would please me more to send you out of here, with the peace of mind that your family will be provided for in the unlikely event of your death, I have to run a business here. If you can't at least show me some collateral, I can't give you a policy.
This authentic pirate relic, a genuine tooth from an actual pirate, only one of its kind.
Is that real gold?
The finest known to man. Not much spit on it either anymore.
Now you're starting to speak my language. All right, let's find a coverage plan that suits your needs. And you can rest assured that you've provided for your family well after your unfortunate departure.
What are the terms of this plan exactly?
It's quite simple, son. When you die, whoever holds that policy gets a lot of money.
A lot of money? Wow.
Wow is right. Now I want you to be careful out there.
Okay, I will. Thanks.
No, I'm serious. I want you to be very, very careful.
Will do. Hi, guys. I guess you'll be wondering how I came to be back from the dead. No questions for the dead guy come back to life? No questions like, is there life after death or is there a heaven? Will there be adequate parking? Fine. Be that way. I wouldn't tell you about the hereafter if you begged me.
That jar's for my tips. Put it back.
But I was gonna put a whole lot of money in it. Too much for me to carry around with me. So I'm gonna have to take it with me and fill it up.
Oh, okay then.
I thought if I died, I'd be buried with your aunt.
Well, isn't it obvious?
You can't be buried in the Good Soup family crypt unless you're a member of the Good Soup family.
A member of the family, huh? I'm off to explore the rustic charms of Blood Island. Baron C. Lambert Chowder Good Soup, pioneer of crouton technology. He looks a lot like the guy at the bar. I'd better get rid of this incriminating picture frame. What? It's locked. I guess I'm better at this pirating thing than I thought. It worked! One nail will never be enough. I'm not sure if that's strong enough to hold it. I might need one more. There. The bed has been nailed down. That ought to do it. The Good Soups, A Life in Pictures by M.M. Good Soup. There, I've cut out the face.
There's nothing like family. No matter what may happen in the topsy-turvy world of the Caribbean resort business, I can always relax in the knowledge that I come from good, wealthy stock. Breeding. That's what's important. Breeding and culture. Just like Grandfather Lambert. Breeding. Culture. And lots of really old money. It makes a man proud. It's funny. I don't remember Grandfather Lambert as looking so common. Oh, weird. It's like his eyes follow me. Pictures like that really creep me out. You just stole that mirror, didn't you?
No, I didn't. It's right there, look.
Hmm, I guess you're right. Oh dear, I'm starting to look old.
From all that drinking.
Mind your own business.
Uncle Griswold, it's me. Don't you recognize me?
Recognize you? I've never seen you before in my life. What is your name?
Hearty Beef and Potato.
Hearty Beef and Potato?
I come from good Irish stock.
I don't recall having any relatives with that name.
Look at me. Don't I look just like a good soup?
Now that you mention it, you do bear a slight resemblance to my great-grandfather, C. Lambert Goodsoup.
Clammy? Why, folks back home used to tell me all the time. You're the spitting image of old Chowder Goodsoup.
You know, I think you're right. I wonder why I didn't see it before.
I could just talk about good soup history all day.
How about that first fateful journey made to the Caribbean?
Oh, you mean the one that... Baron Salmon Bisque de Good Soup began in 1621?
Exactly. He landed on Scab Island with just a spoon and a dream. In just 4 short years, he had formed the largest chain of all soup restaurants in the Western Hemisphere. By 1635, he had driven the entire Van Salid family out of the Caribbean and had a restaurant empire that spanned the globe.
Actually, the Van Salids were not driven out until 1637, and the Good Soup chain of restaurants and resorts never did become popular in the South Pacific.
Yes, we are. All right, whatever. Well, son, it looks like you were right. Welcome back to the glorious name of Good Soup.
I'm honored.
And as a Good Soup, you're welcome to every benefit the name provides. Instant prestige around Blood Island. A 10% discount at any of the Good Soup resorts in the Caribbean. And, of course, medical, dental, and a 401k. And the best thing of all, if you should happen to drop dead, you will be buried in the extravagant Good Soup family crypt.
It's as if all my dreams have come true. I'd like a drink, please.
Here you go, laddie. He's had a sudden and completely unexpected relapse of death. And just as we were getting reacquainted. As his kinsman, it is my duty to give him a proper burial. It is my solemn vow. Young, hearty Beef and Potato shall be buried in the Good Soup family crypt.
All right.
There's a hole in the ceiling of this crypt. I think I might be able to squeeze through. Wow, it's a tunnel that opens on a deep, dark forest. It looks familiar somehow. As if I've seen it in a dream. Or maybe it's... I don't know.
Great jumping monkeys! A terrifying horde of stunningly rendered rabbit jaguars! They're coming right at me!
Whew. It's a good thing I couldn't get through that hole. I'd be done for. Yikes.
Oh, hello there.
Who are you and what are you doing here?
I am Minnie Good Soup, last in a long line of eligible Good Soup debutantes. I was buried here exactly 1 week after my wedding day. A wedding day that never came.
What happened?
Oh, I was the Belle of Blood Island.
How many people can claim that?
Oh, how the lads adored me. I was courted by the richest, most handsome men in the Caribbean. But all my suitors bored me to tears. I wanted someone dangerous. I wanted a pirate. By the way, what do you do for a living?
Flooring inspector.
Oh. Then one day, a real pirate sailed his ship into the bay. I fell for him instantly, and we became engaged. But he left me standing at the altar, and I died of a broken heart.
Wow. That bites.
Oh, I know.
Were there any other suitors you found attractive?
Well, there was one I could have fallen for. Young Charles de Goulash. He had such a radiant smile.
What happened to him?
You know, it's funny. I don't know. He checked into the hotel one night and I never saw him again.
What happened to that young man you liked so much?
Why, the last time I saw Charles, he had checked into the hotel.
How do I get out of this crypt?
There's no way out of this crypt for either of us. I must haunt this lonely tomb until I've married a man I truly love. And you can't leave because the door's locked.
This is just a shade too creepy for me. I'm leaving.
This is going to die.
Oh, I'm not going to do that again. I think I broke my skull. I'm all skull.
It's your own fault. Stop scaring me like that.
So I did scare you? Really?
Well, startled is more like it.
Oh.
But startled in a terrified kind of way. You really are very, very scary.
Don't talk down to me.
I really don't have any choice.
I saw you get out of that crypt. Does this mean that you're dead?
No, I was only faking.
Darn. I thought together we could walk among the living and spawn a new wave of terror throughout the Caribbean.
So what you're saying is that you only love me for my legs.
Something like that. Hey!
Hey, mister! Help!
What? Who's there? Who said that? Who's scaring poor old Mort, the grave digger?
There's been a horrifying mistake. I've been buried alive in the Good Soup family crypt.
All right. This joke has gone far enough. You kids should be ashamed of yourselves.
It's no joke. I'm really trapped in here.
Crazy kids with your long hair and your Baroque music? Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me.
I'm gonna go sulk in the darkness now.
Have a good time.
I've got it.
Hey, what happened to the light?
Murray, do your stuff.
Okay.
Boo!
Ah!
Mortal fool, release me from this wretched tomb. I must be set free, or I will haunt you forever. I will hide your keys beneath the cushions of your upholstered furniture. And nevermore will you be able to find socks that match.
All right, hang on. I'm coming.
Great work, Murray.
I was terrifying, wasn't I?
My demonic powers have made me omnipotent!
Uh-oh, looks like the lantern ran out of oil.
There. It's open. Now shuffle off and give me peace.
Well, Murray, are you ready to continue our heady adventuring? Murray? Where'd he go? Hey, what an amazing story I have to tell. I was dead, but I live again. Who wants to hear about it? You guys don't deserve to hear a good story. This village is deserted. How curious. I'm Guybrush Threepwood, a mighty pirate.
A pirate, huh? Well, then you must realize the inherent danger in wandering into a village populated by cannibals.
Lovely weather we're having today.
Yes. Lovely.
I guess you're gonna eat me now.
To be honest, the thought had crossed my mind. But we are no longer vicious and bloodthirsty cannibals.
No?
No. We underwent a paradigm shift in our belief system several years ago.
A paradigm shift? You don't say.
We decided we wanted to live a healthy cannibal lifestyle, completely cut back on our fatty missionary intake, and went vegetarian altogether. But there certainly was a time I would have eaten you. Young guy like you, not too much muscle.
Hey!
I'd probably marinate you in white wine for 45 minutes, dip you in a light corn batter. Wrap you in banana leaves and bury you in a pit with 100 hot coals. Let you roast overnight. Then I'd serve you on a bed of basmati rice with a garnish of shiitake mushrooms and shallots.
But not anymore, right? But not anymore, right?
Huh? Oh, yeah, right.
You look familiar somehow.
Perhaps it's because I look like a big lemon.
Oh, yeah. But it's more than that. We've met before. Back on Monkey Island.
Monkey Island. We had a nice village there. Rent-controlled huts close to the good schools. Those were the salad days, so to speak. Till they put in that darned carnival.
Carnival?
Yes, carnival. just as soon as they put up the first tent,
whoosh!
The whole place becomes trendy. Sailors coming in at all times of the night, that awful music droning on and on. And to be honest with you, I think the Midway games are rigged.
Yeah.
At night, it wasn't safe for a cannibal to walk the island alone.
Gotta run. Bye.
That looks like a mask.
Ick.
Finally, you're here. Come on, we're late for the sacrifice.
God of the volcano who resides in Mount Acidopolis, accept this sacrifice we make unto you. In the form of flesh with high amounts of fiber and wholesome cellulose, free of all fat and trans fatty acids, so that it might nourish you and bring your favor upon our humble village, and not upset nor agitate your ulcerative caldera.
Okay, boys, toss him in. You've been a wonderful audience. Thank you, and good night.
You fool!
You've given cheese to a lactose intolerant volcano god. Do you know what that means? You brought about the coming of the divine dysentery. Run for your lives!
Wow, that was more spectacular than I'd hoped. I guess I'll just drag this down to Haggis now. Here, Haggis. This stuff should work to patch up the ship.
Aye, laddie, indeed it should. The consistency of tar, but with a tangy pepper taste.
So, can I have your lotion now?
Aye, lad. Go ahead and take it.
Elaine looks like she's all right.
Hang on, honey. I'm going to get you out of this mess.
It's full of fermenting sugar water used for making rum. It's full of sugar water now. There, I've poked holes in it. It's full of yummy, delicious sugar water. Bet that water sure tastes good. They're trapped inside and glowing like mad. It's that accursed... Let's see if this slippery, greasy lotion does the trick. That should do it. The cursed ring exploded! Boy, it's windy up here. Perfect! The lighthouse is working now. Who are you?
I am the lost Welshman.
Ooh.
I am the ferryman between here and Skull Island. Trapped for so very long in the icy ocean mists. Oh, how I hate that blasted mist.
Really? I like mist. I think it's pretty.
Well, sure, mist is pretty. But egad, is it dull.
I'd like a ride out to Skull Island, please.
I will risk these rough waters no more. For too long have I rocked in that watery cradle of death.
Freaky imagery.
Whatever. Anyway, I'm not going out there again until I'm sure I can make it there safely. I need a compass.
How will being able to draw perfect circles get you out to Skull Island?
Not that kind of compass. The directional kind. If you find me one, I'll take you to Skull Island.
Welcome back to Mutual of Stan.
I'm cashing in this insurance policy. Give me a lot of money.
But this is a life insurance policy. You collect when the policyholder dies.
No, honest. I was dead for a really long time.
And you just got better?
Well, yes.
Do you have any proof of this miracle?
As a matter of fact, smart guy, I've got your proof right here. A death certificate.
Well, this must be some kind of mistake.
It's right there in high-res black and white. I died. Give me a lot of money.
It looks like I'm left with no choice but to acquiesce.
No, just give me my money.
That's what I mean.
Oh, thanks. It's full of seawater. Cool, a magnetic pin. The mind boggles at the possibilities. Okay. Hey, neat, it points north. Science is fun when you know the secret. Here, take this compass.
This is a compass. Will it work?
Of course. See how it points north?
Wow, that's incredible. How'd you do that?
It was nothing. I'd like a ride out to Skull Island, please.
All right, let's go. The bravest of men must dread the horror of this place. Steel your courage, boy, now, before you gaze upon the terrible, horrible face of Skull Island.
That's a duck.
What are you talking about? Don't you see the skull?
This island doesn't look like a skull at all. It looks like a great, big, enormous duck. It should be called Duck Island.
Well, you see, you gotta squint and sort of turn your head and... Ooh, it's just so scary.
If you squint and turn your head, it looks like a bunny.
Well, anyway, see that light up there on the cliff face? That's Smuggler's Cave. It's run by King Andre, the greatest smuggler in the world. And his nefarious assistant, Cruff.
But how do I get up there?
You'll have to go to the top of the cliff.
Won't you be coming with me?
No, you must go alone. There will be someone there who will help you. But I warn you, beware of King Andre. He is as ruthless as he is bald. Good luck.
Thanks. Hello. Can you tell me how to find the evil smugglers of Skull Island?
Beats me. Oh, wait a second. I think I remember something about that at the orientation seminar. Let me think. The cave is halfway down this sheer cliff face. Climb on board this dumbwaiter. I'll lower you down.
It looks pretty rickety. Are you sure it's safe?
No. Never used it before, but I'm sure it can't be that dangerous. I'm a temp here. The usual elevator operator, Braunbeard, he's sick, so I'm filling in.
I guess that'll be okay. What's your name?
It's LaFoot.
Would you lower me down to the smuggler's cave?
Sure, I can do that. You must weigh no more than, say, 20 pounds, right?
Actually, more like 120.
Oh. Well, it can't hurt to try, right?
No, you're sure about this?
Oh, yeah. You don't look that heavy at all. Is that not tied securely? Here we go.
Okay, give me a little bit more slack.
Whoops!
Okay, that's too much slack. Ah! Hi there, neighbor. Got any diamonds? Wouldn't you know, but I'm fresh out.
Go away.
Darn. Let me try that again.
I have got so much money, it's almost embarrassing.
Well, hello. Let's talk, Mr.
Threepwood. Guybrush Threepwood.
Very well, Mr. Threepwood. I am King Andre, and this is my associate, Gruff. Were you looking for something in particular?
The Good Soup Family Diamond. LeChuck stole it, you bought it, I want it. Now. Please? Sir?
But we have so much quality merchandise here at the Pirate Club.
Our prices get lower every day.
Everything a pirate, or pirate in trading, could possibly want is here. For the right price.
I don't get it.
The Good Soup Diamond is the centerpiece of my collection. The fantastic energy flowing through it is the key to all my power.
So, can I have it?
Of course you can't have it. Unless you were to give me something in return.
That diamond belongs in a museum.
So do post-impressionist paintings, Mr. Threepwood. So do post-impressionist paintings.
What the heck is that supposed to mean?
One day, you will understand.
Do you expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Threepwood. I expect you to buy.
Your evil plan will never work, Andre.
But it is flawless. A carefully placed series of charges laid throughout Blood Island, all controlled by a network of satellites in geosynchronous orbit. And only one man has access to the master switch.
Boss.
I am that man, Threepwood, and...
Boss?
Yes, Mr. Gruff.
Ixnay on the evil Amplay?
Ah, yes, of course.
You're a madman.
Am I mad? Am I? Is it madness to sit in a cave at the top of a deserted island, accumulating vast amounts of gold and jewels and stuffed animals, stockpiling plunder from across the Caribbean and passing the savings on to you? Is that madness or genius?
Good point. I take it back.
I'm not crazy. My prices are.
Maybe I'll just take a look around. There's nothing sadder than a lone smuggle bunny. It's adorable and functional. Even packed into confined spaces, they're still adorable. I couldn't help noticing those adorable smuggle bunnies.
Ah, the smuggle bunnies, one of our most popular items. Each one comes with a cleverly hidden pouch just above the small intestine.
Great, I'll take one.
None of them contains the diamond.
Oh, never mind. How about toys? Do you have any toys?
As a matter of fact, a new shipment just arrived yesterday. They're sure to be bestsellers. Here, take one.
You're the best shipmate ever. Land ho, sailor. Let's build a sandcastle. I'll be haunting ye into the hereafter.
I really had my heart set on that diamond.
As you wish. You are a formidable opponent, Mr. Threepwood, but it looks as if our game of cat and mouse must cease. It is a perfect diamond, one of the largest I've ever seen.
I'll take it.
And so it comes with a very large price.
Enough with the hard sell. How much?
It will cost you an awful lot of money. Do you have that much?
Well, I have a lot of money.
Not enough.
My partner is right. We can't give it to you for anything less than an awful lot of money. But perhaps we can make a deal. My partner and I are very fond of cards, poker in particular. How about a little wager? If you can defeat us at poker, you win the diamond.
Sounds fair.
Yes, fair.
Could you stop laughing like that? It's very unnerving.
So, Mr. Threepwood, the question is to you. Care to join us in a game of cards?
Sounds fun. Deal me in, Baldy.
You will have to pay to enter the game.
Well, how much do I need?
Not very much.
Sure, I can handle that. This is a lot of money. I better only give them part of it.
Have you ever played poker before, Mr. Threepwood?
No. Would you believe this is my very first time?
Then I'll give you a brief explanation. The game is the simplest variety of five-card stud. I deal five cards to each of us. We show our cards to each other, and the player with the best hand wins.
Well, how do I know what makes the best hand?
If you have any questions, just ask us. You do trust us, don't you?
Of course I trust you.
Very well. Let us begin.
Come on, sevens.
Take a moment to look at your cards.
Two of spades, three of hearts, four of clubs, eight of clubs, and king of diamonds. What a terrible hand.
Sit down. We're playing here.
I was just stretching my legs. I want to keep playing. I've got a really terrible hand.
Apparently, good fortune is not in the cards for you.
I thought we agreed you weren't gonna laugh like that anymore.
I have a full house. Aces over kings. You lose. Perhaps you should try again.
You bet! I'm gonna win that diamond.
Put up your side of the wager, Mr. Threepwood. Very well. Let us begin.
Come on, sevens.
Take a moment to look at your cards.
Five of a kind. Right there. Not even you guys can beat five of a kind.
You're correct, Mr. Threepwood. We cannot beat five of a kind. The question remains, however, whether or not you can beat a pair.
A pair?
A pair of murderous smugglers.
Huh?
Us, Mr. Threepwood. I'm talking about us.
We're gonna kill you.
Oh, I get it. Whether or not you can beat a pair, that's pretty clever. Now, gentlemen, let's not be too hasty.
There's a delivery man out here with a package.
You idiot! You blew out the lights!
I got the diamond.
Not for long, you little...
Ouch! Hit him, not me, you cretin!
Who are you calling a fool?
There he goes! Get him!
Got what I needed from the smugglers.
Good. Let us leave this place of evil. Good luck on the rest of your adventures, Guybrush.
What? You can't mean...
I'm afraid so. This work is too dangerous for me. I'm going to find a more stable, secure line of work. I hear there's still an opening for a chef on Scab Island.
Well, you'll be sorely missed.
I know, but my destiny lies out there, somewhere. Beyond the rolling waves.
Farewell, good friend Welshman.
Oh, wait. Where'd you say Scab Island was again?
East by northeast. You can't miss it.
Oh, thanks a bunch.
Ah, whoops. I forgot to tell him that a magnetized pin will only have compass-like properties for a short time.
Have you found her, you cadaverous canine?
Nope. She's not on Plunder Island, Captain LeChuck.
Then scour the seas, you ossified rats! Hunt them down, then bring them to me. Find me Guybrush Threepwood. It's with him that you'll find Elaine. Burn down every island in the Caribbean if you have to.
but bring me my bride and more slaw! Cursed obstinance! They never give you enough slaw with these battle meals!
I didn't hear you come in. I was just... Charles? Charles de Goulash, is it really you?
Minnie, it's been so long.
Oh, Charles, it has. It has. You look so different.
Really? Why, you look exactly the same.
Oh, Charles, how you flatter me. Oh, but you must go now.
But why? Now that I've found you again after all these years.
What would our families say if they knew we were alone together on such a romantic night?
Minnie, this may sound rash, but I love you, Minnie Goodsoup.
Oh, Charles, you mustn't.
Oh, I can't help it. I've always loved you. Do you hear? I've always loved you, Minnie, and I always will. Come away with me now.
Elope? Oh, but Charles, it just isn't done. Think of the scandal it would cause.
To heck with the scandal, Minnie.
Oh.
Marry me.
Oh, yes, Charles. Yes. 1,000 times, yes.
Then kiss me, my love.
It's a massive diamond engagement ring.
Blood Island, sir.
Hit them.
Are you all right?
Guybrush? When? Where are we?
You're okay. We're on Blood Island. LeChuck's ring had a terrible curse on it, but I put everything right. You're safe and everything's gonna be fine. Just fine.
Be well spoken, pet. But save your breath, lass.
You'll be needing it for when you scream, "I do."
Where are we?
Don't you be remembering this place, Threepwood. 'Twas not long ago that I trapped you here to suffer tortures most foul.
Wait, I can remember. I've seen this place before in some terrible nightmare.
'Twas no mere nightmare, Guybrush. Search your feelings. You know it to be true.
Oh, no. It can't be. But it is. This is the Carnival of the Damned.
Aye, the Carnival of the Damned.
You fiend, why have you brought us here?
There'd be two reasons, you pathetic privateer. I'd be intending to torture and kill ye. And I'll be giving Elaine a treasure.
You're wasting your time, LeChuck. Elaine's love can't be bought.
Ah, but this be a very special treasure. This be the fabled treasure of Big Whoop.
Big Whoop?
Aye, the very pirate treasure you were searching for before I caught up with ye.
What's so special about the treasure of Big Whoop? Isn't it just like any other pirate treasure?
I see. Ye do not yet know the dreadful power that be Big Whoop.
I guess not.
Quake in fear, Threepwood, when I tell thee that Big Whoop be a damned portal to a demon netherworld.
Okay.
The treasures of Big Whoop be the very gates of hell themselves!
Yipe. But how will Big Whoop make Elaine love you?
Elaine shall pass through the hoary gates of Big Whoop, just as I once did. Down to the inky blackness of the infernal nether regions. For you see, Big Whoop gives those who pass through it the greatest gift of all, immortality.
But at what cost?
Cost? Granted, people may find me a bit unapproachable now, and the smell does take a while to get used to. But it'd be worth everything now that I have the power to make Elaine love me.
But if you kill Elaine, won't she hate you even more?
Aye, at first. But soon she'll be understanding what a grand gift eternal life be. And besides, the dating pool be surprisingly small when you're the living dead. She'll just have to give me another chance.
This whole amusement park, why?
The Big Whoop Carnival was my most brilliant idea. Once I had the power of Big Whoop at my command, I could make Elaine mine at last.
I see. But again, why an amusement park?
I'll be getting to that. I knew Elaine would need a little coaxing, and that I'd be needing an army. A horrible army of the undead.
Okay, but why an amusement park?
Are you going to let me finish? I'm not talking just to hear myself talk, you know.
You're right. I've been rude. Please, go on.
Everyone knows that the life of a seaman is a long, hard, lonely one. Sailors spend months longing for just a few days' leave. And you know what they're looking for as soon as they get into port. A family-oriented fun park!
Oh, that. Of course.
They come to take a ride on the giant roller coaster, the Great Monkey Mountain. They reach the top of the highest peak, and then hands in the air, screaming like monkeys. They plunge down the slope into a great stream of lava.
That doesn't sound the least bit fun.
Aye, it's not. In fact, it's downright unpleasant. But when they reach the other side, they're fitting warriors for my skeletal army of the damned.
How did you find Big Whoop?
That'd be a long story. Are you sure you want to hear it?
Does the torture start after we're done talking here?
Aye.
Go on then.
Back when I were alive, Elaine despised me.
No.
No, it's true. I can see that now. She didn't like me at all. But I were determined to prove me worth to her, you see. So,
I set sail to find the legendary secret of Monkey Island.
What is the secret of Monkey Island?
The secret of Monkey Island. I could tell you, but I'd rather make you guess.
That a sequel can never be as good as the original?
Lies! Filthy, dirty lies! No, it goes much deeper than that. It's an ancient secret, closely guarded by the natives and pirates who happen to...
You don't even know the secret of Monkey Island, do you?
No, not really.
All right, then. Let's get on with your story.
A few days after setting sail, my ship was caught in a terrible typhoon and was torn apart. I would have drowned, but some friendly sharks found me and set me ashore on Blood Island. There I was, marooned, with no hope of winning Elaine's heart. I thought my luck had run out, but one day a ship made port at Blood Island. 'Twas the ship of one Captain Marley, Elaine's own grandfather. I struck up a conversation with Rum Rogers Sr., first mate on the ship. And for the price of a few drinks, I learned that they had the map to the legendary treasure of Big Whoop. Although I had no ship and no money.
Hold on. I'm sorry, were you saying something?
Although I had no ship and no money, I planned to beat Marley's crew to the treasure and take it for myself. I didn't have the money to buy a new ship, but I still had my greatest asset.
Your immunity to soap?
But I still had my greatest asset. That indefinable LeChuck charm. One of the rich young debutantes on Blood Island was helpless against it. After a week with me, she would have followed me to the grave. Unfortunately for her, she didn't get the chance. I pried the diamond from her family's engagement ring and sold it to some cutthroat smugglers for the cost of a new ship.
You scoundrel!
I've been called worse. With me new ship, I easily overtook Marley's crew and beat them to Big Whoop, which just so happened to be here on Monkey Island.
What happened to Captain Marley and his crew?
Their ship arrived at Monkey Island a half hour after mine. But they were too late to stop me from claiming me prize. And they watched me pass through the portal of Big Whoop. Craven cowards that they were, the power of what they saw overwhelmed them. They fled the island in terror. Marley tore his treasure map into four pieces and gathered his crew around him. There was Rum Rogers Sr., the first mate, Rapscallion, the cook, and young Lindy, the cabin boy. Marley gave each a piece of the map, keeping one for himself. They promised to guard those map pieces with their lives. I saw to it that they kept their promise. They were the only people alive to know about Big Whoop.
What happened to Rum Rogers Sr.?
He was taking a bath in his cabin near Fat Island, drinking rum and eating toast, as he always did while bathing. When the toaster mysteriously fell into the tub with him.
Shocking.
His son inherited the map piece, but was too much of a drunkard to understand its importance.
What happened to Rapscallion, the cook?
Rapscallion died in a flash fire in his weenie hut on Scab Island.
That's right. I brought him back to life with a voodoo spell. I remember it so vividly.
Guybrush? Guybrush?
Oh, I'm sorry, I was miles away. What were you saying?
I knew about Rap's absent-minded tendency to leave his gas burners on. So I arranged for a fully lit cake to be delivered to him on his 35th birthday. Ha ha! You can hear the explosion as far as Booty Island.
That's horrible.
Steaming weenie indeed.
What became of young Lindy, the cabin boy?
Fearing for his life, he came to me and begged for mercy. In return for not revealing the location of Big Whoop, I let him live. As a sign of me gratitude, I gave him a fortune, which he used to build a successful advertising firm. Once he had grown accustomed to his wealthy lifestyle, I returned to collect me debt. I delivered to him an account so demonically ill-conceived that it was doomed to fail. Gangrene and honey. Within a month, he was penniless and insane, a broken man. He sold everything he owned and got so desperate, he fell in with a traveling circus. He was killed when he was shot from a cannon without a helmet.
No one could be that desperate. What fate befell Captain Marley?
I ambushed him while he was racing in the America's Cup. I boarded his ship and decided to let him determine his own fate. He could grant me his blessing to have his granddaughter's hand in marriage, or he could suffer a death more horrible than any of his crewmates.
Well, what'd he say?
Actually, he said quite a few things. Oh, the pain. Stop it, you're killing me. Some other things, I forget them all. I left him for dead and sent his ship into a whirlpool not even the most accomplished captain could escape.
You're unbelievably ghastly and wretched.
Oh, thanks.
Elaine will never marry you. She loves me.
She does not. She loves me.
Nuh-uh. She loves me.
Does not.
Anyway, Elaine really loves me.
Does not.
Does two love me?
Does not.
Does two infinity.
Does... Curse you and your diabolical debate skills.
I've heard enough of your evil stories. Let's get this over with.
But there'll be so many more horrible things I'd be wanting to tell you.
I'm not listening to you anymore. See, I'm ignoring you.
You'd better listen!
La 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 la, I can't hear you. La 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 la.
Very well, Freeport. If you're going to act like a child, I'll help you get in the mood. I think you deserve a timeout, young man.
Uh-oh. It's not locked. Your plan was flawless, LeChuck, except for one minor detail. That will be your downfall. He's taken Elaine on his roller coaster of death. I've got to reach her before she becomes his undead bride. What's happened to me? Dead. Foggy, can't think. I'm swimming. Must concentrate and rescue Elaine. I've got to save Elaine. But how can I save Elaine when I'm just a little boy? Oh, if only I could think straight. Must clear my mind.
Welcome to the Big Whoop Carnival, little guy. Come on over here and meet your old pal Dingy Dog.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Yo, Murray.
Hey, it's you. Are you dead yet? You look different.
Not dead, Murray. Just cursed.
Cursed? That's perfect. I'm cursed, too. Let's join our cursed forces together, and together we can rule the world.
Yeah. Let me get back to you on that. How can I win one of these fabulous prizes?
Well, that's easy, matey. If I can't guess your weight or your age, you get to pick what you want.
What's the catch?
There's no catch. It's just that easy.
I'll bet you can't guess how old I am.
Bet you I can. A little fearsome buccaneer like yourself must be 7 years old.
Ha! Wrong. I just so happen to be 20.
Well, do you have any proof for your old pal Dingy Dog?
You calling me a liar?
You bet I am.
I have my proof right here.
Scum Actors Guild membership card. Guybrush Threepwood, age 20? I suppose you're right. Pick your prize.
Give me that anchor.
Well, take it away, son. Congratulations. Enjoy your stay here at Big Whoop.
Look into your heart. I'm the prize you really want. What? You picked the anchor?
It's a really nice anchor, Murray. Sorry.
I can't believe
I've got a pie pan full of shaving cream. Now it's a heavy pie pan full of shaving cream.
What good is a dumb hunk of iron anyway? What are you doing over there?
I found this pie, mister.
Huh? Oh, yeah, thanks, kid.
Shoot it, shoot it.
Not right now.
Oh, but I want to see the cannon fire.
Beat cheeks, half pint.
Look, man, I pay your salary. You want me to tell the check you've got unhappy kids running around here?
Okay, okay, you little... Did you just hear something?
No.
Weird.
Maybe it's the acoustics of that smelly giant head.
Shut up, kid. It's not even a real anchor. I'm a real talking skull. After all we've been...
Yoo-hoo! Stinky Mr. Rat!
Hey! Get out of there, you little punk!
What are you gonna do about it, vermin boy?
This'll teach you! Fine! Take the stupid anchor! You would have made a lousy undead monster anyway.
Now that's not very nice, little boy. Come on now, stop hitting your pal Dingy Dog.
I'm going to wait for an owner.
I'm not gonna warn you again, kid. You better cut that out.
Get out of here before...
Yeah, you're really starting to bug me, kid. All right, that does it. You're going down, little punk.
Ow, he bit me.
Hey, give me back that hair, kid. You're ruining the suit.
If you value your life, mere mortal, you will flee before Murray, Scourge of the Living, and Uber Skull of the Underworld.
What kind of snow cones do you have?
What kind of cones, did you ask? Why, I have every kind imaginable. I have the most distinct type of snow cones in the world. In fact, my cones are so original, so inventive, and so... unique, that most are completely inedible. Let me list some for you. I have sweet cones, meat cones, cold cones, mold cones, bold cones with lime, cones with slime. Veggie cones, wedgie cones, hedgie cones. I used some of my neighbor's edge in that one. Cones with spice, cones with lice, berry cones, hairy cones, dairy cones. And the Christmas, oh, 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 merry cones. So, what do you think of that?
I'd like a plain snow cone, please.
Okay, kid.
peppery goodness. Ooh, hairy. That meringue looks tasty. He's so cute. Aren't you the cutest little thing? Ugh. The pepper helps, though.
Brain freeze.
I had a feeling he'd turn up sooner or later. It's Rum Rogers Sr. as he appeared in life.
Only you. Have you seen Elaine? She told me she was just going to powder her nose, and I haven't seen her since. I can't be believing I fell for that one again. Now stand still, boy, so I can flame broil you. Oh, how cute. Let's see the little bugaboo run. Will you be, mate?
Hey, that's not very nice. Uh-oh. Ouch! Ow! It's a Dynamo Monk Electric Wally. Gad, he looks so lifelike. Hey, wait a minute. It really is Wally. You can count on me, Wally. Just as soon as I defeat LeChuck, save Elaine, set all the monkeys free, and ride the madly rotating Buccaneer, I'll come back and release you.
Me coaster, why haven't you been boiled in me molten pool of lava? Elaine must have fiddled with me controls and rerouted the tracks. Aye, she'll be the death of me yet. I mean, again. But curses if I can't help but love the little woman. Eat flame and death, Grapewood.
Oh.
Ouch! Ow!
There. It's soaked in oil and probably highly flammable.
Cool.
It's LeChuck.
Aye, Threepwood. It be me, your worst nightmare. You'll be sorry you ever set foot here on Monkey Island when I'm through with you. Arr!
Run, mortal! But do not forget your arch-nemesis, Murray! Mark my words, I shall return to haunt you! Do you hear me? I shall return!
This is so unfair.
Carnival is great, Dad.
It sure is, son. But you know, rumor has it that the man who built this place is buried here. And they say that to this day, his frozen body remains in the tunnels somewhere beneath the amusement park.